You, but subscribe you. Percuma saja tu you. Tidak pakai duit tu you. Boleh ba kalau kau you. Pasti kau tak gagal you kio.
You know, if you make it to the upper bracket, you have the easier path through the grand finals.
All right, it's time. Welcome to the Land of Dawn, potentially the final time. Can RSG bring it back, or will the Boromir's Gruuls walk out of this group with a perfect score? Let's find out.
Maybe here with the Akai. He was denied of the Jawhead, though, but the Hilda is back.
Oh, he is, and that's really interesting. Kid decides to take the lunge first, and he just dashes right through everybody to get some significant damage here. But again, RSG with the early game composition, they've got the Hilda, they've got Jason, and Sync. Oh boy, he is getting low.
And Sync here tried to push his luck there. And you know what? As long as the Harith is hugging the, you know, the turret, he will be fine.
Yep, he will be okay. And Ruby DD, he is very, very healthy. But yes, coming back to the main topic we wanted to get to, the lane assignments. It looks like Brody did decide to go into the mid lane with the traditional Akai support. Ooh, Sana stealing away the River Crab there. He's going to get a good trade, especially when he pops that passive against against D for now. But yeah, it's going to be Harith into the off lane.
So Kid here is a mid lane Lance, but that is going to be a pickoff onto that Lancelot.
Yeah, not exactly the best here, but again, Lancelot isn't too strong in the early game, especially when he's up against some really strong early game heroes like the Farsa, like the Hilda, so it's expected, but I really hope that he didn't die there.
Yeah, I mean, it's nice to see Burmese Ghouls have this, you know, strategy where Lancelot is actually the mid laner. That this is a new take on the hero.
I mean, that's what they used to do with him in ages long gone. Yeah, yeah. Oh, Ruby DD! Can he survive? No, he does not. Jason ensures that he lands the feathered airstrikes really, really nicely. Kid just looking to just push that wave. Sana on the top side. He's getting a lot of pressure off of Ace here. Ace taking a really bad trade overall, but was able to get his ult at the very end just to even up the score.
And right now, you can see Kid and the others. KZP using the concussive blast to his advantage. Maybe he's just way too tanky, but look at this RSG. They might be at a very bad spot right now.
Yeah, they are, and Sana's just building up charge, and the rest of the team, they're kind of low here, but Jason going to be using that feather airstrike to make things work. Kid looking for an opportunity to take him out, but Yishun Shin takes him out instead. Sana so very, very low.
And without the Lancelot getting, you know, the buffs, the orange and the purple, there is a significant lack of damage in terms of, you know, the burst that the Thorn Rose, Puncture, and the Phantom Execution can do.
Yeah, and unfortunately, it didn't work out, but, you know, it's fine. Burmese Ghouls, they fall behind a little bit. RSG is just slightly ahead. If they can pull through towards mid-game, I think it lightens up.
It gets better in time, but that's the key word there. You need time. You need to stall the game for a bit. Try to give Kid time to get you know gold, and probably an endless battle, you know, a Heptasis.
Yeah, those would be some great items here. Oh, KZP playing with fire, but he is just making sure that he is doing as much damage as possible. Unfortunately, he's going to be giving another free kill over to Kid.
And Hilda went over the limit there, overstepping his boundaries, and he gets punished for it. Kid at level 5, and as you can see, Ace here, he really likes to go for these marksman-ish junglers. Well, not-ish, marksman junglers.
Oh yeah, for sure. I mean, just look at the amount of damage he's doing. Who doesn't want to play these type of junglers, right? And now Ace, he's going to be rotating down towards bot side here. Sync is just, he's holding his ground. He doesn't really want to show face too much, but Sana is going to take a little bit of damage here. LY4 dropping down the Mountain Shocker, and they realize Benedetta sees what's happening as they dive top side, while on bottom side, they dive instead, mirroring each other absolutely perfectly.
Who's going to get the turret, though? That is going to be the question. Will it be an equal trade, or will someone get the turret? just to make it a bit better for their side.
Oh, God. Yeah, it looks like it's going to be an equal chain. Ah, the flame shot isn't going to connect and lands onto maybe instead. Jason taking a little bit of damage here. He's going to get some damage on towards Ace's side. He's going to do as much as he can before he goes. And Ace on the run. KZP can't really do too much. He only took the concussive blast. If he had something else like the high and dry, he could have done so much more damage, but he knows his limits.
You know what? While Turtle everything was that of that was happening onto the mid lane, top lane turret goes down into the hands of RSG, so they have a one turret advantage versus Burmese Ghouls. Mm-hmm. RSG, they're trying to, you know, divide themselves, scatter themselves onto the map, try to get that much needed information for them to fight.
Looks like the Feather Airstrike lands on literally no one on that side on that time, but then the Mountain Chopper comes in pretty good. KZP able to flicker on out of there. Sana trying to buy some time, but doesn't manage to go through. Now Ace, he gets hit by the final blow. Sync finally getting some retribution over a terrible laning phase, and he makes it through 3-1 in favor of RSG. But that's not all. Harith is coming in with the Zaman Force to try and turn things around. KZP, with a single sliver of health through BDD, has done all he can do.
Nice backup there coming up from Ruby DD. What he did was he didn't really want to go for the kills. He just wanted to protect the turrets. If he got the kill there, that should have been a bonus. But for the side here of RSG, they got the turtle, and LY4 is going to be protected for some time.
Yeah, LY4, he's going to slowly scale into this game, and he's taking killing spree as well, so he is going to be looking mighty fine if he chains those kills together. However, on the bottom side here, it looks like the Hurricane Dance has been popped and locking down. It's going to be Sana. He can't get out of this. He doesn't have any more options. KZP just buying some time, but this could be a potential dive angle. It looks like they're just going to back away. There are no other objectives to take on the map.
Ace just having a good time at the bottom lane, just trying to get the crab coin. Nothing much happening into the laning right now. Well, not the laning, but in terms of the fighting right now. But look at Jason. He is using the Farsa, and I have yet to see how aggressive he is.
Well, I mean, he hasn't gotten too far ahead into the game, but so far his mechanics have been, you have to admit, on point. It's some of the fastest feathered airstrikes I've ever seen in my life. The transformation, he's just at it. But now RubyDD getting some good amount of damage, especially on that Zaman Force. The Chrono Dashes, he feels nothing. Jason gets a good chunk on him. However, D on the right flank forces him out of position. Looks like that feather airstrike not going through, and KZP has to pay the price.
It seems to me that Burmese Ghouls, their chemistry, their synergy and their communication is just on point.
It's crisp. It's like really, really crisp.
Yeah, it's steady. It doesn't really, you know, I don't think there is anything trivial when they talk. It's just like always on point. Like,
they're just spitting
come
facts
here.
At each other.
Come here. Lapu, come here. D, come here. We need you. That's it.
Or better yet, they're just saying names like Lapu. Got it. They don't even need directions. They just know. And maybe he goes on top of Sync. Sync might be taking a little bit more damage than he should. However, Rakid gets caught out of position. Nowhere to turn. But going forward, tries to run away through the tower, but gets punished instead.
Almost. Almost. Got out. But the Feathered Airstrike was there. And you know what? D here is trying to, you know, just help his allies secure this turtle.
Oh
and,
no, maybe
oh
finding
goodness.
A great pick. He uses the flicker and the Hurricane Dance. Jason now in a lot of trouble, maybe on the back line, getting hit by Sing Benedetta with the final blow, cuts him down.
RubyDD just staying here in the brush. He's trying to see if Jason will come his way. He's going for the recall. RubyDD shows himself.
Yep, he doesn't mind. He doesn't mind. Jason's gonna stun. Oh, did he land the stun? No, he didn't. Yeah, oh, he gets it again. And even Sana, just to ensure that he cleans up house, he's gonna look for one more. Finds the kill onto Ace, using his execute as well. Kid manages to survive.
He's never scared of pulling out that feathered airstrike.
Oh,
even if there's a Harith near, he would opt to go and kill the Harith rather than just going back safely.
He has no fear of death. It's just, oh, I'm gonna die? Okay, I'm just gonna maximize my value with this little bit of health.
So that is one of the things that you really have to look at a very talented, a very brave player.
Yeah.
Such as Jason and LY4. They have the Blade of Despair on their pockets right now. Burmese Ghouls. It seems to me that their change of pace from the Yisun Shin to the Brody isn't really working as well as the time that they picked the, up the Yisun Shin.
Yeah, I definitely think that this is a different pace for RSG. They're feeling they're playing again on their comfort pick. Sana is in the role. Sana is in a comfortable role on a hero where he can do a lot of work. Sync, very mechanically talented player, finally gets to go back into the offlane with the Benedetta, which he's been playing a lot as well. Look at that! Just ooh, sweetie, swoot, I am out of here.
And the passive is just, you know, I think in a way it's kind of a bit broken that you get called out by the Hurricane Dance. But then again, you can still dash out. But Sync here, eye for an eye. Mm. Dodging a lot of damage procs there that could have took him down. But eye for an eye is eye for an eye.
Oh my goodness, was that just the... What? That was literally just the flame shot. That was just the flame shot. He lost half of his health. Oh my goodness.
Man.
Can we see the items?
Man. Jason is at an 8-1-2 record. That is his KDA. And if you would look at the items, it's the Clock of Destiny, Lightning Truncheon, and I think he's gonna go for the Holy Crystal next.
Yeah, I didn't start with just those two items. Wait, let's look over the kid's side here, because he only has a Blade of Heptisea, so only naturally he is going to be a little bit behind compared to the rest of the core members on his team. So, okay, things are starting to add up a little bit more.
Mm-hmm. And KZP, just getting that immortality on his side. He doesn't really have those solid defense items. But look at this, Ruby Didi going straight for that Farsa. Brody goes down. Look at Benedetta and the others. Kid can't do much. Thorn Rose doesn't really hit as much as your jungler Lancelot. But Sana here will be the next target.
Oh, they're struggling.
And that is going to be the knock-up. On to Akai goes down. D here is the next target. Ruby Didi trying his best. He doesn't have the Salmon Force anymore. And RSG will just back out. And that was totally a win for their side.
Absolutely. A 2-for-1 trade in favor of RSG. 8-15 on the kill scores. Ruby Didi wants to go for it. Sees an opportunity. Takes the opportunity. Drops down the Salmon Force. 1v3. Final blow. Doesn't connect. Ruby Didi gets on out of there. But Sync ain't gonna let him go that easily. Execute finally being brought down on him.
That's the thing. I mean, if you have Electo Final Blow and you line it up with the Zaman Force, you automatically force out the Harriet from the Zaman Force. Now, if Harriet wasn't forced out, it could be a lot of shield procs going to his side, and he might survive that. But the fast thinking of Sync here is put the Electo Final Blow on that certain area, force him out so that he doesn't have the low cooldown of the Chrono Dash.
Oh yeah, and now Kit, he goes down almost straight away. Maybe doesn't get there in time. Ace, he's holding his ground. He is scared of going back into this fight. He's gonna have to kite on backwards, but if he walks up any further than this, he's gonna get caught in the crossfire. Another two picks going on for the Boromese Ghouls. It looks like RSG are taking this game seriously now, as Ruby DD gonna be struggling to pick up Sync here, who is on the run. But Ace, he wants this. He's got the orange buff, but Sync, he refuses to get caught out of here. He doesn't have the final blow this time. He is still on the run while the rest of his team have been able to net themselves another turtle under their bank.
It's just way too annoying. RSG here play a masterful showing of on how to run this kinds of lineup. And Jason got what he wanted. He wanted to give pressure, and right now he's at 9-2-2.
I said turtle didn't die.
You did.
I meant Lord.
It's fine.
Oh, man.
It's fine.
That was definitely one of those brain fart moments. It's like, wait a minute.
That was the Lord.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
But it's fine.
I'm getting old, man. I'm getting old.
Well, aren't we all?
Aren't we all? That is true. That is truth. But now, with Lord crashing down into it, this... Oh, wait. No, this is going to be the Siege of a Lifetime. RSG are in prime position. Luminous Lord as well. Sana goes in for the full engage. Manages to cancel out the Phantom Execution. This is it. It's going to be RSG trying to pull this over to a game three. But not if BG are going to have anything to say about it. A huge ult coming out of Kid from D as well. Getting for the big stun. RSG forced to pull on backwards.
Wormy schools refuse to back down. They will fight for their lives. It's the only thing that I can think of. sorry.
It's a really catchy song.
It's a really catchy song. It's not my fault.
Oh, boy. But yes, the Burmese ghouls are pulling it back, but they do only lose an inhibitor turret here. RSG are in a very, very prime position to steal this game away and force it to a game three.
Mm-hmm. But at least good news for Burmese ghouls fans out there. At least now Ace got hold of the buff.
Yeah, he did. He finally did actually get the buff and sink. Look at him. Look at the amount of pressure he provides. He is just clearing these waves like they're absolutely nothing and then pulling attention to himself.
Mm-hmm. And it's not like they can take him down without the Hurricane Dance. Mm-hmm. And automatically, if he gets caught by the Hurricane Dance, it is going to be go time for the side of RSG. And look at this. Harith goes down. Maybe he's gonna survive. Maybe he's not.
They're gonna go for the full-on dive here. Sana already under the tower as well. They look for a little bit more. KZB runs up as soon as possible. He is max stacked out, so his ult will hurt.
Spicy movement coming out from RSG. They're just taking the fight straight to the Burmese school side. Look at this D with the Lapu-Lapu. Look at the damage output. Wow.
Yeah, it's looking good. And right now it's a 3v5 situation, and Ace has to make the best of this situation as well. He's looking for any opportunity to try and get a pick off here. Mountain Shocker is going to be dropped down. Everybody dashes around, but unfortunately they walk over each other, and Kid gets hit by the overlap. He wants to go for a little bit more, but better not. Takes the wave back to safety.
Burmese ghouls right now, if they make another error like that and they lose two people or lose two heroes on their side, that might be the game.
But yeah.
Then again, we have to look at the timers right now. Looking at the Lord, no one can die at this fight.
No, not if they start the fight like this. I mean, maybe already using his Hurricane Dance to try and look for the pickups off of that purple buff. But again, RSG just seemed to be a little healthy here with Kid dying so quickly to the amount of burst that RSG has. But that's not all. D still caught in the middle of this situation. He is going to be able to get out. No, he does not. He gets caught out in the end by Sana and 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 by Sana.
He was part of the fight, actually.
Well,
he was just stuck in a 1v1 with Brody.
That's one of those situations where it's like, didn't catch you. Okay, I'm gonna immediately look to play hyper efficient and go down to bot side.
And sink. Oh. They got the Farsa. Step in the right direction.
All right, it's looking good. Ace. Final blow. Sink. Can he pick up on Ace? Yes, he does. He picks him up. And now Sana is going to be right in the middle of that fight. They get a mega kill. And this is going to be Ace. He's already down. And the rest of the team are scrambling to get back in. They need to play for that defense. Sink down on bot side to get the wave pushing. Maybe is the next to fall. He's going to come back up with the immortality. They don't pick him up again. All right, but it's going to be another inhibitor tower going over to RSG side. They have an endgame position here. Can Burmese ghouls hold out?
RSG just doing a great job just taking the fight to the side of Burmese ghouls, and right now they are collecting every buff, every objective, and the Lord is marching down onto the bottom lane. And for me, LOY4, he is trying to just get more monsters. It's probably for the potion.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to get the potion on his side.
Yeah, with the next Lord coming out, this could be it. This could be the game that pushes that RSG with the comeback from Phantom Execution coming out to the back where I can't seem to get rid of LY4, who is gigantic here, but Zeke in the front line. Nobody can stop him no more as they look to break that crystal with the help of Lord. And there you have it. RSG bring it over to a game three. 1-1.
And the day just won't end that easy. On and on
we'll go. Never seen someone handsome with one eye. I'm not fat, just chubby.
On, turn it on.